हाय चिल्ड्रन, आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर इज लाइट। मेरा दैट लाइट इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी। इट प्रोड्यूसेस सेंसेशन ऑफ विजन। वी सी थिंग्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ आईज। आईज हेल्प अस टू सी द थिंग्स। दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सेंस ऑर्गन अमंग द फाइव सेंस ऑर्गन्स। Eyes are the most important sense organ. We can see the beautiful world only with the help of eyes. But if there is darkness, can you see anything? No. Even though we have eyes, we can't see the things if there is no light. So a light enables us to see the things. So this is the basic things about light. Light is a form of energy. It produces the sensation of vision. It enables us to see the things around us. Reflection of light. We have studied in previous classes about reflection of light. We can just recall it. When a ray of light falls on a smooth surface, this is a smooth surface like a mirror. In mirror, one side is smooth and polished, and the back surface is opaque or it is not polished. When light falls on this mirror, what will happen? It will bounces off into the same medium. So this process is called a reflection of light. The bouncing off of light when it falls on a smooth surface is called a reflection. Here the ray of light PQ, we can name it as PQ. PQ is the ray falls on the mirror. So PQ is called incident ray. The ray which incident on the mirror, PQ. Then QR, we can call QR is the as the reflected ray. QR is the reflected ray. And the point Q, this is point Q. Q is called the point of incidence. The point of incidence. So the ray PQ falls on the point Q, and after that it will get reflected. And QR is the reflected ray. There are some laws related with the reflection of light. So which are the laws of reflection of light? Before that, we know that when PQ, the ray of light falls on the mirror, it will get reflected. And this is called the point of incidence. At the point of incidence, when you draw a normal by using a protractor, draw a normal at Q. We can denote the normal by using a dotted line. So this dotted line, we can name it as N dash. This represents the normal on the surface. Then this angle, there is an angle formed between this normal and incident ray. We call this angle as I. I is called an angle of incidence. Angle of incidence. I is the angle between incident ray and the normal. Normal, how will you draw a normal? Keep the protractor over this surface and draw in 90 degrees. Yeah, along the point Q. So draw a line connecting this 90 degree and Q. And this angle between this normal and incident ray, that is called an angle of incidence. So what will be the angle between the reflector ray and normal? This angle is denoted as R. Angle R, this is called angle of reflection. So we got two angles, I and R. As for the first law of reflection, there are two laws of reflection. The first law states that angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. Angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. That means if you keep angle I as 30 degree What will be the value of angle R? It will be also 30. If it is 45, if I is 45, R will be also 45. So whatever may be the value of I, R will be also having the same value. This is the first law of reflection of light. The second law of reflection of light. As per the second law of reflection, the incident ray, which is the incident ray? PQ. PQ is the incident ray. The reflector ray is QR. And the normal, which is a normal? N, N dash is the normal. The incident ray, reflector ray and the normal all lie in the same plane. That means this will be, all these rays will be in the same plane. When the plane changes, this rays will not exist. So incident ray, reflector ray and the normal all lie in the same plane. So these two are the laws of reflection of light. Next, we are going to recall the image formation in plane mirror. When you stand in front of a plane mirror, you can see your image in the mirror. And what are the specialities or characteristics of this image formed in the plane mirror? So what may be plane mirror? Plane mirror means the reflecting surface is plane. The common mirror that we are using in our home is plane mirror. Plane mirror, back surface will be showing as shaded. So what are the characteristics of the image? Suppose you are standing in front of a plane mirror. You can see your image inside the mirror or in the mirror. What type of image is formed? First of all, we can say that, is it erect or upside down? Erect means however you are standing, the same way image is formed. Upside down means lower portion becomes this upper part and upper portions becomes the lower part. This is upside down. What type of image is formed in plane mirror? That is, you know that it is erect image. So an erect image is formed in a plane mirror. So inside the mirror, you can see your image, an erect image. So the image is erect, first characteristic property. The second one, what's the second property? Is it of same size or bigger or smaller than you? You imagine that you are standing in front of a mirror. What kind of image is formed? Is it bigger one or smaller one or same size? We know that it is of same size. Same size as that of the object. So this is the object. The person standing in front of the mirror is considered as the object. This is the image. Image has the same size as that of the object. So we got two characteristics. This is the third one. What is the third characteristic property of the image? This image is a virtual image. Virtual image. What do you mean by virtual image? The image that can be formed on a screen. Screen may be a wall. Can you focus your image, the image formed in the mirror onto a wall or a screen? No. But by using some other mirrors like concave mirror, we can form the image on a screen or a wall. So if you can focus the image on a screen, that type of images are called real images. At the same time, if you can't form the image on a screen, that type of images are called a virtual image. The next property is, object and image are at same distance from the mirror. Object and image are at the same distance from the mirror. For example, if you are standing at a distance of 1 meter from the mirror, image will be also at a distance of 1 meter from the mirror. If you move forward, this image also will come towards the mirror. If you move backwards, image also will move backwards. So always this distance remains the same. Object and image will remain at same distance from the mirror. The next characteristic property is, that is very important one, that is lateral inversion. What is lateral inversion? That means if you raise the right hand by standing in front of a mirror, the image will raise the left hand. So there is a side change. Our right side will be the mirror's left side. If you raise the left hand, the image will raise the right hand. So this property is called a lateral inversion. We know that in the ambulance, in the front of the ambulance, the letter ambulance is written in, it means upside down. Why? Because in mirrors, this property lateral inversion is there. So when a driver looks through this side view mirror, he can correctly read as ambulance. If it is written properly, that is correctly ambulance in front of the mirror, it will be seen as inverted image in mirror. So to avoid that, this ambulance, the name is written upside down. So these are the characteristics of image formed in plane mirror. The first one is the image formed is erect. Erect means the same position, that means the head up, then what was the position of the object, the same type of image is formed, same size. Virtual image is formed, object and image are at same distance from the mirror. The last one is lateral inversion. So these are the characteristics of image formed in a plane mirror.